My favorite song on the album is Memory Lane.
Alright, fuck that shit. Word, word. Fuck that other shit, you know what I'm saying? We gonna do a little something like this, you know what I'm saying? Keep it on and on and on and on and...
It's so... You know, to hear an 18-year-old be that wise about what he was experiencing. And to be that in tune to his music and in tune to the street and in tune to what the streets wanted to hear was amazing. So we celebrated the success of the album by doing an album release party in New York the day before the album hit the stores. And we thought it would be a small gathering of people that we invited, and it turned out to be a zoo. And we had gotten Nas a limo, pick him up on the bridge, pick up him and Jungle and Grand Wizard and his whole crew, 40 side of running. And he had a cell phone. We were like, yo, pull up to the front. It was bonkers outside. Like, it was bananas. And he saw the craziness. He rolled down the window, did one of these, and kept going. I listen to Illmatic all the time. I wouldn't say, I'd be lying if I said I listen to it every day. But it stays in the CD player, it stays on the iPod. I'm very proud of the things that I've been able to accomplish and the things that I've been involved in hip hop and in my career. But I try to move forward, and I try to, the best I can, not live in the past. But there are those moments when I'm on a plane or I might be by myself in my office, and I'll throw it in, you know, just to give me that refresher course of what New York used to be like and what my life used to be like, you know. It's just a great body of work, you know. And my friend Faith Newman said something really interesting. She was on the red carpet at the premiere of the film, and somebody said, like, why do you think this album is still relevant today? And she said, well, why do you think Catcher in the Rye is still relevant today? Why do you think The Godfather is still relevant today? Why do you think Mozart is still relevant today? Because it's a body of work that stands the test of time. You know, it's that album. It's that relevant part of the history and of this culture that if you're truly involved in it, you know, not marginally involved, but if you're truly involved in the culture of hip hop, that it's a must listen at least once in your life. You know, I think every generation in hip hop has that artist that has the it factor. I think it would be fair to say that 10 years ago, Kanye West's first album, College Dropout, is relevant the way Nas is relevant. I think some people would say that Drake's first album is probably as relevant as Illmatic is relevant. These were albums that seismically changed the culture. What Illmatic means to me is perfection. I know that's, people might be watching this and going, what the hell does that mean, perfection? Illmatic is 10 songs. No throwaways, no records you had to put on there because a producer had to get paid. No forced records on the album. It's 10 songs. My favorite critic write-up was the one in Rolling Stone when they gave it, you know, their equivalent of 5 mics. They gave it 4 stars. They said, our only complaint with Illmatic is it's too short. It's only 37 minutes. It's 37 minutes of perfection. Like, you can't capture that again. And I love a lot of albums. I think Wale is a tremendously talented artist. I love The Gifted. I listen to it nonstop. I think J. Cole is tremendously gifted. I think Born Sinner is an album I listen to nonstop. But Illmatic to me means perfection. And that only happens once in a lifetime. You know, you're not gonna see that again. That's perfection. And Illmatic is perfection. And for all the people watching this who fans of Power 95.3 and fans of this radio station that might be listening to Young Thug, or 2 Chainz, and loving that part of the culture, and listening to August Alsina, listening to YG, you need to take a moment and listen to Illmatic and really understand what perfection is.